So I guess the idea for this acoustic show in Northampton came about, well, first things first, it's 5 years ago to the day, almost, we played our first ever show.
6 years.
No, five.
December 2004, we played our first show just down the road at a club called the BBC. And so we thought we'd like to commemorate that somehow, doing something special. And we've always wanted to do something that's just stripped back, almost like Nirvana Unplugged when they did that show in New York. It just came kind of instilled in my mind as something that was just really a real great showpiece. I would say that this performance is for us and for the fans, but probably, and it happens rarely, this is probably more so for us, which is we really wanted to do it, and it's something that's really fun for us.
We've wanted to do this for a long time.
But on the other side of things, you know, people are going to be coming tonight, as I said before, are going to be seeing things that have never been seen before, that we've never played live, and we might not do again in this format, so.
Who knows?
It'll be good. Hello, everyone. How are you guys doing? So I think we're about 5 years ago to the day almost, we played our very first show as Fightstar just down the road. So we thought it'd be a nice way to commemorate it by playing some songs for you on acoustic tonight. So I hope you guys enjoy it. This is it's the first track we ever released. It's a song called Palahniuk's Laughter.
Take my time. I wonder how fast you could cry. Woo!
Thank you.
The other thing that's really nice about the show tonight is that we, on our last record, Be Human, we got a girl called Audrey Riley to conduct all the strings, and she wrote a lot of the string parts that went on the record. We worked with a huge 24-piece orchestra, and she's coming tonight to play cello for us. So it's going to be really nice, you know, to have her back with us. And we were rehearsing last night. It's just really nice to, you know, be able to play with her. And also, you know, we love string, the sound of strings, and to have a bold cello accompanying us is only a good thing.
It's a treat.
There's a funny story there as well, because Audrey turned up last night having learned 3 songs. She walked through the door and said, oh, well, we're not doing those 3 songs anymore. So she had to actually write and ad-lib all the parts she's playing tonight in half
about
an hour.
10 hours, yeah.
So, but she's a very, very skilled musician, so she just went through like
she's
that.
Like a machine of musical death.
She is. Acoustically, though. Acoustic death.
That was funny. Last night, Charlie was like, I don't want to fry your brain, Audrey, and she was like, Charlie, you're not frying my brain.
This is far from
because
frying.
To her, like what we play is
this
ridiculous.
Is a light, light braising of the brain. No frying.
Yeah.
Not frying. I'm sure she's not even around my brain.
So, our new album, Be Human. So you guys that have heard it will have heard there's some pretty awesome string arranging going on, and that is purely a result of this lady, Audrey Riley. So everyone give her a huge round of applause. It's very nice to have her with us tonight. Steve, can I get a tiny bit more acoustic guitar, please? This is a track off our second record, and it's called 99.
Oh, love.
Thank you.
When you put it in this stripped back light, it feels like we're playing new songs again.
Yeah.
It's really bizarre. Just because they sound different and they feel different, and we add little changes in the melodies and stuff, and you can write some new parts. It does sound like we're playing a fresh set.
There's a whole energy that we've had over the last few days rehearsing that it's kind of hard to get that sometimes when you're doing the full band set, especially when we're just rehearsing. I think the last couple of days has really sort of felt like, it's really fun again, because it's something different for us. Loads of
nostalgia. Some of these songs we haven't played for 4 years, so when you start playing them again, you're immediately transported back to that time where you used to be playing.
The good days.
There's something about muscle memory and the sound, that really takes you back to the point where you could almost taste what you were eating.
You can taste the burrito from the Clapham rehearsal space.
They weren't good, man.
So, we thought we'd mess around with the arrangements of some of these, well, not arrangements, but the sound of some of these songs. It's one of my personal favourites, this one. It's a little bit of a Spanish vibe to it. But this is a song called The English Way. Let's get some clapping going. Give up on
song about Terminator.
Yeah.
But let's be clear, 1 and 2, nothing to do with 3 or Sarah Chronicles.
No.
When we went to record the second album in LA with Matt Wallace, we turned up to the rehearsal studio and he was gonna come in and listen to all the songs in a live format. And he turned up on the first day and and we hadn't written like all the album yet, and we didn't know how to play all the songs we'd written to go there, and he just fucking walked out. He's like, right guys, fuck you, like I'm gonna go away for 2 days, and if you don't know them by the end of the two days, yeah, I quit. You can fucking go home.
And he said we're the worst, most unorganized band he worked with in 25 years.
Yeah. And then he went away, and anyway, that is the period we wrote Last Common Ancestor. We didn't like rehearse this.
And Tannhauser Gate.
And Tannhauser,
yeah. No, it wasn't Tannhauser, it was Death Car.
Death Car.
So we had the chorus for Death Car, but all the riffing was all written in that day.
Yeah.
So it was our Last Common Ancestor.
So was it T2 or T1 that really kicked off that lyrical spree right there?
I would say T2.
T2 all the way, man.
But that ethos of Matt Wallace's strop really kicked us into gear. Like.
It did.
It's actually... Yeah, I mean,
he's one of the nicest guys. Like, yeah. not portray him as like a real boss.
I think that was the only real he had, but it was justified.
Yeah.
We tend to start the writing process of the songs off on acoustic guitars, and then we'll to get the kind of meat and two veg, as it were.
A good judgment of whether a song is good or not is if it works just on one acoustic guitar, you know?
Yeah, maybe two.
Then everything else, the whole, maybe two. Then the whole band adds to it and, you know, it makes it even better and everyone brings their own little thing to it, which in essence is a good song in the beginning. So yeah, it's nice to strip everything out and showcases like kind of how it evolved
originally
from the
formed.
Beginning.
Mm. Now we're playing Sleep Well tonight and that song came as a result of Chaz leaving his acoustic next to a radiator for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And it went into some crazy tuning that no one had ever figured out to do before. He picked it up and went,
bing, bing. Let's see. It's one of my favourite tunings. It's so weird.
I think the tuning's like sack gack.
Yeah, sack gack.
It's the radiator tuning, yeah.
No, that sounds horrible. That's
and, you know, that's just... the sound of an acoustic is unbeatable in some ways.
It sounds...
acoustic?
Like an acoustic guitar.
Yeah. Yeah.
Cool. So, this is a track of our first record as well. Goes out to Fred, who's doing our merchandise tonight. It's one of his favourites. It's called Sleep Well Tonight.
Yeah, we're basically going to be. We were playing a couple of covers that we haven't done before, which is going to be cool because we thought just want to mix it up a bit tonight. And that's the other thing. It's not just that we're playing songs we haven't played before. You know, a lot of these songs no one will have heard in this format. So it's just for the fans. It's cool because they get to see a real stripped back version of where these songs would have originated from.
The delicate side of Fightstar.
Yeah.
Okay, so basically, I don't know if you guys might have heard, but we did Radio 1 Live Lounge about a month and a half ago. It sounds quite random, we did a Jordan Sparks cover, and it's called Battlefield. It's actually through to the semi-finals, so next week, I think we're up against the Arctic Monkeys, and who else? Who else are we up against?
We had to choose a song, and it had to be quite current, and we were not sure what to do. And our radio plugger suggested Battlefield. So anyway, we had a go, and it turned out all right. And it's actually got nice melodies in
it. Who else are we up against next week? Arctic Monkeys and who else?
30 Seconds
to Mars. 30 Seconds to Mars, yeah. Okay, so basically, if you hear it on radio next week, then text him, because I want to win it. Now we're in it, I want to stay in it to win it. So just text him. Yeah, this is Battlefield. Don't try and explain your mind, I know what's happening here. One minute it's love and suddenly it's like a battlefield. Things tear us down. My world's nothing when you don't. I'm not here without a shield. Both hands tied behind my back with nothing. These times when we climb so fast to fall again. I don't want to fall for it now. You never meant to start a war. No, I never meant to hurt you. I forgot what we're fighting for. What does love always feel like? A battlefield, a battlefield, a battlefield. What does love always feel like? A battlefield, a battlefield. Can't swallow a pride, another of us gonna raise that flag. Surrender, we're both gonna lose what we had. Both hands tied behind my back with nothing. These times when we climb so fast to fall again. But I don't wanna fall for it now. I never meant to start a war. No, I never meant to hurt you. I forgot what we're fighting for. What does love always feel like? A battlefield, a battlefield. A battlefield, why does love always feel like a battlefield? A battlefield, a battlefield. I guess you better go and get your armor. Get your armor, get your armor. I guess you better go and get your armor. Get your armor, get your armor. We could pretend that we are friends tonight. And in the morning we'll wake up and we'll be alright. But maybe I just don't wanna fight. This love to feel like a battlefield, a battlefield, a battlefield. What does love always feel like? You can sing along, it's okay. Battlefield, a battlefield. I guess you better go and get your armor. Get your armor, get your armor. I guess you better go and get your armor. Get your armor, get your armor. What does love always feel like? A battlefield, a battlefield, a battlefield. Love always feel like a battlefield. Yeah, man. Now, to some of you, like, should I sing along? Should I not? It's a bit. Cheers, dude. This next song is a cover by a guy called Don McLean, and it's basically going to be the B-side to City on Fire when it comes out. Is it tomorrow?
No, the 21st.
Oh, 21st. Comes out, like, in a week's time. And
please,
this is, this is like an old school song, but I just one of my favourites. I just really like it, so we thought we'd do it. And it's called Vincent. So here we go. Starry, starry night, paint your palette blue and grey. Look out on a summer's day with eyes that know the darkness in my soul. Shadows on the hills, sketch the trees and the daffodils. Catch the breeze and the winter chills in colors on a snowy linen land. Now I understand what you tried to say to me, how you suffered for your sanity, how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now. Starry, starry night, flaming flowers that brightly blaze, swirling clouds in a violet haze, reflect in Vincent's eyes of china blue. Colors changing hue, morning fields of amber grain, weathered faces lined in pain, are soothed beneath the artist's loving hand. And now I understand what you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity. How you tried to set them free. They did not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now. For they could not love you, and though your love was true, when no hope was left inside on that starry, starry night, you took your life as lovers often do. But I could have told you, Vincent, this world was never meant for one as beautiful as you. Starry, starry night, portraits hung in empty halls, frameless heads on nameless walls, with eyes that watch the world and can't forget. Like the stranger that you've met, the ragged men in ragged clothes, the silver thorn of a bloody rose, lie crushed and broken on the virgin snow. Now I think I know what you tried to say to me, how you suffered for your sanity, how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they're not listening still. Perhaps they never will.
Out the Stars when we were rehearsing it. It was really sounding good.
Yeah, that's a song that we wrote. It's one of the first songs that we wrote. And it was on our original EP. And we played it once. We played it once when we wrote it, and we never played it again. So that's going to be something that... And we all, so many people ask us to play it live, and we never do, so...
It's a real special one. I think it's one of those tracks that we don't think about enough, because it really is suited to acoustic shows only.
Yeah.
It's we never really put it in any of our sets because it just never really fit in with what we normally do live, which is usually quite a heavy, punchy show. So it's really nice to be able to revisit it and bring it out because, I mean, as you said, it's been in the cupboard for the last 5 years pretty much.
So we want to play a song that we... Again, we played live when we wrote it, but we wrote it. It's one of the first songs I think we ever wrote. It's on our EP, They Liked You Better When You Were Dead. And it's going to bring back some pretty crazy old memories. It's called Cross Out the Stars. And it goes something like this. Show my face around you. Thank you.